Hi everyone and welcome back. This is Paul from TechLink, and in this video I want to show you how you can recover and restore your data on a computer in a few easy steps. Now, data is the core of our digital life. We store all our memories, hopes and dreams in data, which can be lost due to many reasons. And if you are watching this video, you probably encounter data loss as well, which is one of the most common computer problems we might have. This can happen for many reasons, like files deleted by accident or due to malware or virus infection on your computer. So in today's video, I'm going to introduce you to a very powerful software that can help you recover your lost data in an easy way. As I mentioned, the software is very user-friendly, so you don't need any advanced knowledge on data recovery. I'm also going to show you all the benefits you can get from this software, and we'll do some testing on different types of storage to put the software to work. And I also have an incredible perk just for my viewers, so make sure to watch through the whole video to find out everything you need to know about it. Now, for the purpose of this video, I'm going to use an old hard drive of mine. I'm also going to test the software on a micro SD card to show you that it actually works. So the first thing you want to do is head over to this website here, 4dd.tenorshare.com. And as you can see, there's a Mac version as well. So if you are using a Mac, you can still use this software. But for the purpose of this video, I'm going to stick to Windows so I can show you how it works on my Windows 10 laptop. And what you want to do next is click on the free download button in order to get the installer file. Now, as you can see on their website, there are many use cases for their software. You can recover deleted files, lost partitions, and so on. And it supports pretty much all kinds of files you can think of. So you can restore images, videos, music files, office documents, or whatever type of file you are looking for, with each one of them in tens of different formats. And as I mentioned at the beginning of the video, it supports all kinds of storage, from memory sticks to memory cards, cameras, music players. It even supports floppy disks if you have any left from the Stone Age. So to get back to the setup, once the download is completed, you need to open the file and allow it to make changes to your system and press the install button. It's just going to take a few seconds to install and then you can use it straight away. Once it's finished, press start. Now, as I mentioned before, the software is very user-friendly, so once you open it, you're going to see all the drives and devices connected to your computer. Also, if you deleted something from your desktop or emptied your recycle bin, you can use one of these options without having to scan the whole drive. Even better, if you know the location where the deleted files used to be, you can click on select folder, which will bring up a kind of a browser so you can navigate to that specific location. Another feature that might be useful for you is the advanced repair, which allows you to recover from a crashed computer. More specifically, this will create a bootable USB or DVD drive, which should help you start up your crashed computer again. Also, if you click on this three lines button in the top right corner of the window, you're going to get a drop down menu from where you can select a different language if that makes it easier for you, or you can access an online guide, which you won't need if you are watching through this whole video. Now I'm going to connect through my USB the hard drive I showed you in the beginning. This should appear in my computer. And there it is, drive V. I do have some data on it, but we're going to see if the software manages to find anything else on this hard drive. So I'm gonna go back to the software, select drive E, and click on start. When you do a full scan, it's going to take a few minutes. I think it's based on the size and data transfer speed of that drive. Also, I wanted to take a second to explain to you how this is possible. Now, normally when you delete something, you think it's gone, but the truth is that even if you press shift delete or empty your recycle bin, that data is still there. Now, don't get me wrong, this is not some kind of hack where you can restore endless amounts of data. To give you an example, let's say I'm going to delete a file from the hard drive I'm scanning right now. That file is just not going to disappear from the disk, but it's going to be moved to another part of the disk where it's going to be scheduled for overwrite. So unless you add more data which could possibly overwrite that part of the disk, your file is still going to be there. And that's why it works best with recently deleted data. Another scenario might be if your drive is gone corrupted and it can't be read. This software is able to access that data and restore it for you. I see it's taking a while, so I'm just going to skip till the end. So the scan is complete and you're going to see all of the files found during this process in this tree view tab, where you can simply browse through them. Now, if your drive had other files on it like mine, it might seem a bit confusing to find what you are looking for, but I've noticed most of the times that data you are looking for is going to be in this lost location folder or in the deleted files, so you can check there first. Even better, the feature that I like the most is this file view tab, which allows you to search a file by its type. So let's assume you deleted a video and want to restore it. You can simply click on this video folder and search it in there. You also have some filters you can apply, so you can search your files based on some parameters. Like, let's say you are looking for a picture. You know it's probably going to be around 1 to 10 megabytes in size. So you can bring down the number of files based on that. Also, if you do remember the name of that file or folder, you can simply type it in this search bar so you can find it straight away. Once you are happy with your selection, just press recover, and you're going to need to select the path where you want to restore those files. So yeah, and you need to press recover. Very important, do not restore the data on the same drive. And there it is. This again will take a few seconds or minutes, and after that you can access those files where you save them. I'm also gonna scan the micro SD which I showed in the beginning of this video, just for the purpose of testing this software on different types of storage. So I'm just going to insert that in my USB and it should appear on my computer. And there it is. Wow, that's even better. This drive is not accessible. The files are corrupted and unreadable. So this is going to be like the supreme test. The drive does show up in the software. So I'm going to select it and scan it to see what we find. I'm just going to skip till the end so I don't make this video longer than it already is. Now, as you can see, the scan is complete and the software did manage to find over 900 files on a drive that wasn't even accessible. By looking at these folders, if I had to guess, this was probably some Windows booting drive which I used in the past, and for some reason it was unreadable. So yeah, the software has passed the test in a fantastic way, I would say. Now, as a full disclosure, Tenorshare did pay me to create an unbiased review for their 4D Dig software, and I accepted doing it because I believe it truly is a very powerful tool when it comes to data recovery. I even managed to recover an old crypto wallet of mine with Dogecoins in it from back in the days. Nothing major, I didn't got rich, still doing videos for pennies. And in all honesty, I can't recommend this enough. Also, as I mentioned in the beginning of this video, I do have a special perk for you. Tenorshare and I reached an agreement, so every viewer of my channel can now purchase a license of the 4D Dig software with a 30% discount. I'm going to leave a link in the description from where you can download the software and also a 30% coupon code. So if you are looking for an efficient way to recover deleted data, make sure to use that code so you get a major discount. With this being said, it's time to end this video. If you found it useful, please give it a thumbs up and leave a comment down below so it can reach other people. And like always, thank you for watching and I'll see you next time.